Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we are going to talk about picking the best ethanol mix for your custom tune. And a lot of people have been asking me this lately because, you know, they're upgrading their setups, maybe getting upgraded fueling or an upgraded turbo, and when they're getting their custom tune, they want to make sure they're picking the right ethanol mix so later on, you know, you don't feel like you're leaving a lot of power on the table and things like that. So I'm going to try to answer the question pretty simply, and then I'll explain why I recommend what I recommend. So long story short, I always recommend starting with E30. And the reason why you want to do this is because you're primarily concerned about two different things when you're adding ethanol and tuning for ethanol. So the first thing, and probably what you're most concerned about, is increasing octane. When you add ethanol to your pump gas, it increases the octane, which allows you to make more power. And most of you probably know that the B58 is a relatively high compression engine, and pairing that with a turbo makes it really sensitive to running on pump gas. So you can't push it very hard on, you know, 91 or 93 octane or 95, 98 RON, you know, whatever you have at your pump. So a really easy way to increase the octane is to add ethanol to the mix. And the more ethanol you add, the higher octane your fuel will be. And then in turn, you'll be able to increase the boost, increase the timing, and safely make more horsepower. So I'm going to put this chart up on the screen to kind of illustrate what we're talking about. But basically, if you have horsepower on the side and ethanol content on the bottom, you can see that the more ethanol you add, the more power your car will be able to make for any given setup. However, there are downsides to running ethanol. Primarily, you're going to hit the fuel system's limits a lot sooner. And the rule of thumb is if you're running E85, you need 30% more fuel to make the same amount of horsepower as you would on 93 octane. So let's say on your setup, you're tuning on pump gas and then you hit the octane limits and you can't do anything without adding more fuel. If you switch to E85, you're going to need 30% more fuel to make the exact same horsepower and then even more fuel to continue turning it up. So that's why you run into the fuel system limits pretty quickly, because E85 needs more fuel volume to make the same amount of horsepower. So if we go back to the chart, you're kind of going to have an inverse relationship, because as you add more ethanol, you're going to hit your fuel system's limits sooner. So you'll actually have less power capacity as you add E85 and increase your ethanol content. So now that we've kind of got both lines overlaid, you can see right in the middle, there's like this perfect sweet spot, and that's E30. What that's going to do is make sure that you're adding as much octane as possible without running into your fuel system's limits that prevent you from turning the car up higher. So it's kind of like that perfect middle ground to give you extra octane, extra boost in timing without, you know, pushing your fuel system to its limits. And this is something that was actually recommended to us by Pure Turbos a while ago, as well as, you know, a lot of the tuners. So I did a lot of testing myself. If you guys have been following my channel for a while, you'll know I've gone from pump gas to ethanol mixes, to full E85, and now I'm back running an ethanol mix specifically for that reason. Because when I ran full E85, I was able to tell that I was basically limiting how much power the car could make just for the convenience of running full E85. Now, I will say that if you're working with a custom tuner, you have a lot more room to work with and adjust your ethanol content if needed. And there are a couple scenarios where I would say that it's appropriate to adjust your ethanol content. So one big one is if your fuel system's limits are much higher than like your turbo and the rest of your engine. So for example, if we go back to the chart, you could imagine that this is maybe like a Dorch stage 2 and a hybrid turbo or like a big turbo setup. If you weren't on a big turbo, like if you were still on the stock turbo, the line would look something like this, right? Because, you know, the turbo's smaller, so it can't make quite as much horsepower. So the line is a little bit more flat. And you can see when you overlay that line, your middle point actually shifts over a little bit to the right. So that is why, you know, with a Dorch stage 2 and a big upgraded fuel system, you might be able to run higher ethanol content, because basically you're maxing out your turbo sooner on lower ethanol content. So you'll kind of have to go through that with your tuner. And if you see that you're maxing out your turbo or, you know, hitting octane limits and you still have fuel capacity in your fuel system, then you can begin increasing your ethanol content to maybe E40 or E50 to try to get a little bit more out of your setup, just because you have that much fuel capacity. The other scenario is if you have auxiliary fuel injection. So if you're spraying meth, if you have port injection for E85, meth, whatever the case may be, then at that point you have virtually unlimited fuel supply. all you're doing is upgrading your low pressure fuel pump and upgrading the injectors in your fuel rail, and you can run as much fuel as you want. So typically in those cases, when people run port injection or charge pipe injection, they run whatever mix they want. They run fully 85 just for the simplicity of it, you know, and different things like that. So it's kind of up to you at that point, but port injection is a completely different realm of fuel supply where you really don't have to worry about ethanol content as much. So those are kind of the cases where I'd say it makes sense to run higher ethanol content if you wish, especially just because running fully 85 is extremely convenient. You know, you're not so worried about getting your mix right. You're just pumping what you get at the tank. It smells a lot better. It has great cooling benefit to help the engine perform better. So a lot of benefits with running fully 85 if you have the fuel capacity to support it. And also keep in mind, that doesn't mean that you can't run fully 85 with any other setup. It just means that you'll be limiting yourself on power and potentially, you know, holding yourself back from what your system is truly capable of. Now, one other thing I want to comment on that people ask me is they see people with like E60 tunes or E70 tunes, and they're wondering where these numbers come from. And I will say from experience and just from people that I've talked to, that typically that means they're running pump E85. Your ethanol content from the pump can vary from 51% all the way up to 85% and still be advertised as E85. So if your local station's E85 only has like 70% ethanol content and that's what you tune for, then people might post that they're on an E70 tune. But I can almost guarantee that they are not mixing a specific E70 mix. They're just specifying that the ethanol content for the fuel they use from their ethanol pump is E70. For example, on my car, when I did my E85 tune, it was actually around like 80 to 82%. So I could have said it's an E82 tune, but it wouldn't really make a difference. I just said it was pump E85. So others are more specific with the actual ethanol content they get. That's all it really is. There's no magic rhyme or reason to getting that content. And the other one that you see really often is E50. And that mix is specific because a lot of people want to make sure that they can hit their target ethanol content regardless of the E85 pump they run into. So maybe you're traveling or, you know, whatever the case may be, and you don't know the quality of the E85 pump stations that you'll run into. In those cases, like I said, it can be as low as 51% ethanol. So getting an E50 tune just makes it really safe. Because if you have an E85 tune and you go somewhere where their pump E85 is only, you know, 60 or 70%, you have no way to increase the ethanol content up to the 85% target you need. So that's why a lot of people run E50, just because it's a nice safe spot that, you know, at least if you can find an E85 pump, it'll be at a minimum E51. And if it's more, then you can mix your fuel to get it down to your E50 target. So yeah, that's my recommendation. If you're on, you know, a DI only setup with just stock fuel pump or a upgraded high pressure fuel pump, stick with E30, start there. Otherwise, if you're maxing out your setup on E30 and you need more ethanol content to turn it up and you have the fuel capacity for it, then feel free to begin increasing your ethanol content from there. And also keep in mind, you can run any ethanol content you want on a custom tune. You know, I ran fully 85 with a TU pump. I know plenty of other people that run fully 85 with a DI only setup. And really, it's not the end of the world. You know, you're just limiting your total power output for the convenience of just running fully 85. So it runs fine. It works well. There's really no problem with it. Just it depends on what you're focused on. I've even seen some people get tuned on like E43 and people ask why. And it's because it's a perfect 50-50 mix of their pump gas and E85. So when you're getting your custom tune, you just put, you know, 3 gallons of 93, 3 gallons of E85 or whatever, 5 and 5, and boom, you've got your mix perfect every single time. So, you know, don't make it overly complicated if you don't need to. I mean, do whatever is most convenient and right for your setup and your goals. But if you do want the absolute most power output for your setup, definitely start with E30 and then work from there with your tuner. So I hope this video helps. Thanks everybody for watching. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-